A tragic scene back in September when police found a mother of two killed. Eliza Fletcher had gone for a run when police say she was kidnapped by Cleotha Abston Henderson, the same man who Alicia Franklin says raped her in September 2021. Franklin wanted her name out there and it known. She consented to a sexual assault kit, hoping it would help find her attacker. But the kit wasn't processed for nearly 10 months. State forensic scientists say the day they matched DNA found in Franklin's kit to Abston Henderson's was the day Fletcher's body was found.
We have focused efforts.
The Tennessee Bureau of Investigation doesn't deny the concerning amount of time it took to process Franklin's rape kit, or the long time it's taking to process the other evidence sent last year to the lab in Jackson that not only included rape kits, but DNA and other violent crimes, firearms, latent prints, seized drugs, and more. The Jackson lab processes the evidence for the entire West Tennessee region, including Memphis. WREG investigators talked to the TBI about this very issue back in 2019. They told us they needed more help and money. Well, that need remains. No one with the TBI agreed to an interview, but they did share their latest data. As of December, it took scientists more than 48 weeks to process forensic biology for sexual offenses at the Jackson lab. 41 weeks for violent offenses and 56 weeks for nonviolent. Firearm analysis took the longest at 63 weeks.
This is very high.
Mechtel Prince is a forensic genetics professor at John Jay College of Criminal Justice.
Untested evidence and waiting for evidence to be tested, I guess, impacts everybody who is affected by a crime.
That includes detectives. She says while waiting on the DNA evidence, they have to rely on other ways to build their case.
They can look at cell phone data, they can look at cameras.
Sometimes that's not enough. Shelby County District Attorney Steve Mulroy.
And it does hamper our ability to investigate and prosecute cases.
What kind of cases could be potentially impacted?
The DNA tests aren't just relevant in sexual assault cases. They can be relevant in other types of cases as well, including homicides.
He says the list goes on.
One of the benefits of DNA is it's extremely useful both in identifying the perpetrator, but also in exonerating an accused.
Mulroy says he's been pushing to get a lab back in Memphis after the TBI moved operations to Jackson to be more centrally located for the region.
I'm not trying to take anything away from Jackson, but it seems like establishing a lab here in Memphis, maybe even using existing facilities and just building out from there, ought to be something we should be seriously thinking about.
He says the quicker the evidence is processed, the quicker an investigation moves, and the quicker they can get a conviction.
If we're having to wait for, you know, close to a year for lab tests to come back, that's going to, you know, thwart that effort.
Governor Bill Lee recently signed off on 25 new forensic positions to divvy out among the three state labs.
Have we had an impact on turnaround yet?
So we've seen small adjustments in turnaround right now.
During recent budget discussions, the TBI director told the governor they need more.
But they are incremental at this point. The challenge still exists. I think salary modernization is going to impact all of this because we're still seeing the challenge of being able to hire people at the salary we offer.
He says private companies especially offer more money, and new employees already dropped out because of the pay. Not to mention, every new hire has to undergo 18 months of training.
You know, it may be years before we see that turnaround time brought down to something more like 3 months, which I think would be more manageable.
Local lawmakers have recently proposed bills requiring the TBI process rape kits within 30 days. All the while, Franklin is suing the city. She contends if her evidence was processed sooner, her attacker wouldn't have been able to commit more crime, a belief others share.
A lot of burglars and a lot of sex offenders are recidivists, and they will continue to commit the same crime until they get caught. And DNA testing is a very powerful tool to connect crimes to each other and catch somebody.
Jessica Gertler, WREG, News Channel 3.